Never attribute to malice that which is adequately explained by stupidity. Hello, everyone. This is Glow Skeptic here. Thank you so much for being here. This is a video response to the latest Tiger Dan video where he just put it flat out that if there is no map, there is no case. And I think it's really ridiculous. And I'm putting this quote here because I think it's a good reminder to everyone that it's really easy to judge people's intention, right? Say, oh, he's a paid shill, or he's a psyop, or a gatekeeper, or whatever, right? Well, these are accusations that need supporting evidence beyond conjecture. And it can just be explained by someone who went on a quest with the wrong assumption. And this is where I want to take you. So the basic assumption of mapping is that we live on a globe, right? Cartography, the idea that we have longitude and latitude, all those things, are they are set up, is based on the fact that we live on a globe, right? So if you go to the USGS, which are the expert in cartography, we go to the different kind of projection, and when we go to the globe projection, they tell us that direction, distance, shapes, and area are true. This is the true representation of our world. And if we take distances between continent, if we take the size of the continent, everything, it's supposed to work perfectly fine. But you and I know that water doesn't curve for miles and miles. We know that gyroscopes have no drift, which would have to be because of Earth's rotation, and on, right? I won't list all the different proof that people brought up about this issue of no curvature. But here we have, he took on the task of take cartography based on the assumption of a globe and tried to plot it on a 2D model. And as you can see here, all map projection, including the azimuthal, is based on the assumption of a globe, right? And they're all skewed. All of them, they're skewed. They're, none of them are correct except the globe, right? But it's a oblate spheroid, actually pear shape. But, you know, that's beside the point. And, you know, another thing that we have to keep in mind is that 95% of all flights are in the northern hemisphere. So how difficult would it be to play with the distances and create false routes that of plane that never exist for less than 5% of all flights, right? People are usually pretty poor, and there's not that many people south of the equator. That's where there's less people. So I'm just finding really sad that he came out and said there's no map, no case. Well, if you were beyond an amateur cartographer and you were able to look a different way cartography could be done, then maybe it would take your research seriously. But you're just being a joke right now. And you need to be a little humble to realize that you built your whole case on a faulty assumption. So this is my rant for today. Thank you so much for listening. I appreciate your input. I appreciate your comment. And I'll see you on the next video.